Gaza's Ark is part of the International Freedom Flotilla Coalition's ongoing work to challenge the illegal blockade of Gaza with direct nonviolent action. The occupying Israeli military doesn't always respect the nonviolent nature of our voyages. Some of us, myself included, have been on previous voyages when we were stopped, kidnapped in international waters, imprisoned, deported, and so forth. But the fact is, this sort of violent action doesn't deter international solidarity. On the contrary, it just makes it grow. What we're doing here is rebuilding a boat inside Gaza, something that hasn't happened for many years. So regardless of what happens with our voyage, due to the simple fact of spending more than a year rebuilding a former fishing boat and getting it ready for an international voyage is already sending a signal to the world that the Palestinians of Gaza need their freedom of movement in order to ensure a peaceful future. But one of the victories that we've had even before we sail is that we've put Palestinian producers in Gaza in touch with international purchasers who want to export and purchase and export their goods. So even before we sail, those goods are bought and paid for by buyers in Europe, in North America, in Australia, in South Africa, and elsewhere, who believe in the need of Palestinians of Gaza to have a free and autonomous economy, the ability to sail from their port, to return to their port, the ability to enjoy the freedom of movement that everybody else in the world expects and enjoys, that every other port on the Mediterranean enjoys, and that with that ability, given the ability to enjoy freedom of movement, they can have a peaceful, prosperous, and thriving economy. So this is about economic rights, but it's also about the basic human right of freedom of movement.